Good morning.
Good morning.
Again, I don't sound like this. My name is Nellie Cheboi, and I'm here today in light of global mission. Many of you have seen me around when I worship with you or sang in the choir. Some of you have heard my story. Some of you have been with me every step of the way as I've been pursuing my higher learning at Augustana College. My first snow when I didn't know what to do, whether to work on it or stay indoors the entire time. My first winter when I didn't have the right clothes. My first experience at the dining hall when the food was so overwhelming and I just ate fries and chicken from the time bank. My first Christmas when I couldn't go home because it was so far away and I had no family in the United States. You took me in as one of your own. I'm here today in light of global mission to say thank you for your emotional and financial support. For the few of you that don't know my story or we haven't caught up in a while, I was born back in 1992 and raised in Kenya. I came here 3 years ago to pursue higher learning. Augustana College offered to go to tuition and Trinity Church through programs like Global Mission and Endowment paid for my room and board. With that amount of support, I've been able to pursue my bachelor's free of distraction. Putting everything in perspective, I come from a very humble background, 3 sisters and a mom. My elder sister, Sharon, has a diploma in elementary education and is currently the director at a school I just built for her. More on that later. My second sister, Barbara, has a diploma in veterinary medicine and is practicing back in my local village. Then there is me here at Aggie, graduating in May, and hoping to get my master's at the University of British Columbia in Vancouver or at Duke University. My third sister is Prisca, who just got admitted to high school. The education system in Kenya is a bit different from here. You spend the first 8 years in primary schools. This will be from age 5 to 13. At the end of your primary education, you take a national exam just for 3 days, and the grade you get determines which high school you go to. Elite students are admitted to national schools, the best in the country, with good teachers, motivated students, cultural diversity, and therefore very expensive. Students who don't do as well go to an average school, and those who do badly may be forced to spend another year studying and reviewing the test. This test is only administered once a year in November. I was an elite student and therefore was admitted to a school 3 hours away from home. Given the good transportation here, 3 hours don't seem that much, but believe me, it was out of my comfort zone to go to one of those national schools. The fact that my mom could not afford to take me there, but I wasn't fluent enough in English, did not help my case. I know everyone has a hard time in high school, but mine was a different kind of hard. My mother spent all the resources she had, cows and goats, on the 2 sisters before me in their education. She could not afford to take me there by the time it was time for me to go to high school. The principal would send me home to collect tuition, and I'll just go home, help my mom in her kiosk. So she had a small kiosk where she'd cook food and salad. I'll help her get enough money for transportation back. I would usually take the bus, which tend to be a bit expensive, then sneak back in school, catch up on assignments and what I missed, and keep a low profile. Sometimes food would go by before she notices I was back and send me home again. Then the whole process would begin again. Go home, help my mom in the kiosk, gather enough money for transit, sneak back in through the coffee plantation, play catch up before the principal realizes I was back on campus. She gave up on me 2 dozen times, but it's safe to assume to this day she's not fond of me. At the end of my high school cumulative big tests that go for a month. What you score on this test determines which program you get into. Every 4 out of 84 will guarantee you getting admitted to medical school or any program of your choice. 83 with A's in math and science will get you into programs like engineering or actual science. A 70 gets you to programs like economics, and anything below 65 will require you to go to one of the private schools that tend to be really expensive. If you get admitted into one of the public universities, then you get loans and they tend to be really affordable, more affordable than high schools. Obviously, I was among the elite students and was admitted to a program of my choice, aerospace engineering. Right as I was getting ready for my bachelor's in engineering, a friend of mine introduced me to Zawadi Africa. Zawadi Africa is a program founded by Susan Boyer that takes really bright African girls from humble background and trains them to apply for scholarship in the US and Canada. After high school, you spend a year in the program preparing for SATs, working on your etiquette, polishing your English, and so on. You then apply to as many schools as you can. I applied to 15. The ones that you get in with full scholarship are the ones you choose from. Once as a Zawadi, always as a Zawadi. What that means is that when you come here or go to Canada, you must return home to Kenya after your education and give back to the society. Every month, we Zawadis meet at select locations all over the US and catch up. The awesome part about being a part of this program is that you have someone who has been there before, applied to grad school, someone's already in grad school and can help. Looking to locate back home, someone has already done that and is already giving back. It's always nice to convene once a year and catch up. So through Zawadi, I was admitted to Augustana College, and here I am today. For the 3 years, I've accomplished quite a lot, if I have to say so myself. I'm currently majoring in applied mathematics and computer science, on time to graduate come May. I've done various projects in computer science, written various softwares. I have also, through my work study, been able to provide for my family. The house I grew in was condemned a long time ago. But we kept playing hide and seek with county council because we had nowhere to go. The roof would leak during the rainy season, the doors and windows would close, there was no supply of clean water or any sanitation facilities. My mom, who has been having a lot of health issues for the past few years, had a really hard time recovering while living there. Through my work study program, I've been able to provide for them. I got them a better place to live, good furniture, clean water, a roof that doesn't leak, and a constant supply of food. I've been paying rent and food for quite a while. Last year, I picked up another project, building a school for my sister Sharon, the one with the diploma in elementary education. She's very talented and she was teaching in some of the local schools in Mogotio. When I went home last winter, I found that she was only getting paid $40 a month, which is not enough. Even